Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, WrestleZone would like to welcome you to tonight's live event. Before we begin, please be advised that all WrestleZone stars are professionally trained, so please do not copy or imitate anything you see here tonight. Please also be aware that WrestleZone is proud to provide entertainment suitable for all ages, and we ask that you refrain from using any inappropriate language this evening.
Hello and welcome back to the second episode of the WrestleZone podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. I am back. Yes, I've looked at the figures, I've looked at the view count, looked at the listenings, and we're going to do it. We're going to do the WrestleZone podcast. We're going to keep on going. Well, I'm going to make some changes, of course. I've been trying to stop doing that, saying, of course, I'm also going to try and do some fancy stuff and try and cut out some of the waffling bits like me going as well. So we'll see how it goes. We'll see how it goes. We're talking about Aberdeen Anarchy on this edition. We'll get the results for the RIP Training Academy show up in a moment as well. And we're on the road to Aberdeen Anarchy as of recording. I'm recording this a couple days before release, and the card is stacked. We've got seven matches on the main card, one on the pre-show. That's what's the plan. You may come into 10 minutes into this episode and I've said something totally different, but at the moment, it's seven matches on the main card, one on the pre-show. I'm starting at 5:30 at Danestone Community Centre for VIP ticket holders. The full show starts, I think it's about 6:00. I will check that, though, when I get the poster up, when it goes up behind me as well. I'm going to tell you. I can't wait for this show. It's one of the highlights of my year, going to Aberdeen Anarchy. And originally, this show was supposed to be at Unit 3, but they've changed it. I'm glad, only because I don't know where Unit 3 is. That's pretty much the only reason. I have seen from likes of Adam Morrison, of course, he said, and I'm still doing it, he said that it didn't look like a great venue at all, in his opinion. So I don't know. I don't know where Unit 3 is. Don't know what it looks like. I know nothing about it. But we're going to Danestone Community Centre, which I do know. I do know where to find it. If I put in Danestone Medical Practice in the old sat-nav, I will find it. I won't be lost in some sort of it's a cul-de-sac of houses and finding my way, trying to find this place and then find out that it was like round the corner where I was at the start. It's just one of those days. It's always one of those days when it comes to me traveling to shows, but it's not me that's driving this time. It's going to be Kelly. Kelly's going to be driving. She's come to the show. That ticket was bought as soon as possible. As soon as Caleb had thrown Bruiser Brad over the top rope. We'll get into that a little bit later on when we talk about the main event. When the Bruiser Brad went over the top rope, that ticket was all but bought. It came down to it. Before I go any further, though, he's asked for a shout-out, so I'm going to give him one. It's Jonathan Geddes. Thank you very much for supporting the show and checking out the episodes with likes of Scotty Swift and our episode 200 as well, with Aspen and Caleb on the SWN podcast. But this isn't the SWN podcast. No, no, no. This is the WrestleZone podcast, so we're going to talk about all things WrestleZone. I'm just getting the results in front of me now for the Training Academy show, and then we can go through those. And we'll talk a little bit about just all manner of things about WrestleZone. And then we're going to preview the show. There's going to be a big rundown done by Adam. Adam's got a big bumper preview prediction and poll on the way. I would like doing those for Aberdeen Anarchy, especially. Like I say, some people think that we do kind of skew a lot to Aberdeen when it comes to content, but it's just because it's the company that I go to as well as enjoy, but it's what I go to, so I know a bit more about it when it comes to what's going on, the storylines and what have you, because I have to rely on a lot of social media content for most other companies, and some are great at putting out content when it comes to their social media, and I can't fault them for it. Like some Community Pro Wrestling and are really good at doing that, but for me, I have to keep I see what's happening, and I can do that at WrestleZone because I go to the shows as regularly as I possibly can. I'm realizing as I turn on the video content, my ears keep disappearing, so I look more and more like a thumb. But let's just have a look at the Training Academy show. You have to put up with that, unfortunately. I was going to just take away that entirely and just have my normal background for when I do my normal podcast for the SWM podcast. But I'm trying to make this different. This is the WrestleZone podcast, so I'm going to make it at least have some graphics of some description. I don't know. Well, we're trying. So, WrestleZone Training Academy show was one we previewed last time. I didn't go to that show, so I didn't have a review out for you. I will have a recap WrestleZone podcast out for you shortly after the actual show. And then later at the end of the month, I'll have a road trip episode of the SWM podcast where I'll talk about my journey at the show. Hopefully I'll have some pictures and clips, maybe a montage. I do like to have a montage and episodes. I forgot at the Rumble. So maybe this time I'll have some content for you to add. But you can check out on things like YouTube. If you're on this YouTube channel now, there's some clips on the shorts of from the Rumble and from previous shows I've been to for WrestleZone. So WrestleZone's afternoon show, they did two shows for the Chain Academy, an afternoon and evening show, which spun out a lot of shenanigans, which leading to matches that are happening on Aberdeen Anarchy. So we'll get into them as we go. So afternoon event at Training Academy, this is on April 22nd. We had Mr. WrestleZone defeating Rhys Dawkins by disqualification. From what I gathered, I could be incorrect here, Rhys Dawkins used his massive Shakespearean book. Mr. WrestleZone may or may not have stolen a Shravani from Omar Muhammad's home. We're not sure. We're not one to accuse Mr. WrestleZone of thievery. However, it seemed like the timeline of events did incur. Mr. WrestleZone got a little bit too keen and stole a Shravani from Omar Muhammad. But allegedly, throw allegedly in there. That's a very important word in Scottish wrestling. Chris Archer defeated Oliver Green by pinfall. And apparently, again, from what I've heard and what I've seen in pictures from the likes of Kirsten Louise, excellent pictures I've seen from her, Archer attacked Oliver Green, continued to attack Oliver Green, and before demanding a match with Mickey Vago, which we'll have footage, should have footage of a little later on in the show. So he attacked Oliver Green with a chair, and Vago came to the ring. We'll get into that a little bit later on. Tommy Raiden defeated Murphy by pinfall, which is a huge win for Tommy Raiden, who's been put in the ring with all manner of huge monsters. Letting up on that when it comes to Aberdeen Anarchy. When we talk about the match he's in, we talked about it in the previous episode. He's got that ladder match. We'll get into that a little bit more. And Captain Al Sterling defeated Mickey Vago, but not before challenging Deacon Matthews to match Aberdeen Anarchy, because he hates happiness, apparently, for Captain Allen. After the match, we'll talk about that. There's some bits and pieces that we'll talk about when we actually preview some of the matches, so we won't go into that entirely. The evening show for WrestleZone at Training Academy in Aberdeen on April 22nd. I'm moving a lot here. I'm very sorry. I haven't said that those two words in a little bit. So we're balancing here. We're balancing me moving a lot and not saying those two words. Bruiser Brad Evans defeated Alex Webb by pinfall. A big bit of momentum going into their match at Anarchy. Connor Malloy defeated Rhys Dawkins by pinfall. Again, a lot of momentum there for Connor Malloy. Double duty Dawkins there, doing two matches on the same day. Unfortunately, he was on the losing end of both of them. One on a technicality because of disqualification, though he may have felt like he was a winner, but he was on the losing end of both matches. Air Miles defeated Ryan Riley by pinfall again, so it shows that both the Fair City Saints and the Foundation of the Future, they both have this level pegging. And in the main event, the main event of Aberdeen Anarchy, Aspen Faith and Caleb Valhalla defeated Ronan King and Zach Dynamite Forever the Future by pinfall. So that's a lot of momentum going on. These guys are going to be on Aberdeen Anarchy, and they're really picking up wins, picking up momentum, picking up some sort of confidence and gaining confidence on the way to Aberdeen Anarchy, which is taking place on May 13th. I would try and show you all some tickets. I'll try and sell you some tickets, but the show is sold out. So I can't do that, unfortunately. As much as I would love to say go get your tickets now, it has been sold out for about a week or so now. So yeah, I can't. I'm so glad I bought mine. I've got a physical ticket somewhere. I should really find that before Saturday. And I can't wait to go. So that's 5:30 p.m. People can get in if you've got your VIP ticket. 6:30 for general. Bell time 7 p.m. That's not right. I have written that down wrong. It'll be 6 p.m. bell time for VIP and 7 p.m. for general as well. So a sold out show. Another sold out show. First time Aberdeen Anarchy is coming to Danestone Community Centre. and it's going to be a big one. There's some matches where I'm like, okay, I wasn't sure about that particular match. I wasn't sure. Oh, well, that seems like a interesting addition to the show. But we'll talk about it soon enough. So that was the Train Academy show. We don't know. There's no other shows announced coming up, so I don't have any dates for you to put in your calendar for WrestleZone shows, but do keep an eye out on either WrestleZone's social media or on our own, because of course I do a lot of the sharing, and we do that as well on the Scottish Wrestling Network. So let's just go dive in to the show itself, Aberdeen Anarchy. Aberdeen Anarchy this year takes place on May 13th, 2023 at the Danestone Community Centre. This is the first time that Aberdeen Anarchy will be taking place at Danestone Community Centre, which has seen shows like Christmas Chaos and possibly Battle of Nations has been that event as well. Danestone is a really nice venue, so a good open plan venue where you get plenty of just everything. There's some great snacks, there's great options. It's a really nice venue for watching some absolutely amazing wrestling. It's also got space for a cage. I don't know if that's going to play into the show at all. At the moment, it's not, though. Of the matches that have been announced as of recording, the steel cage has not been brought into the foray, but there has been ladders, which we'll get onto in a little bit. But yeah, Aberdeen Anarchy in 2023, it looks like it's going to be a phenomenal show as we go through the card. Previous events have been taking place at like the Northern Hotel, which was last year, and the previous events beforehand. Beach Ballroom, of course, being an infamous venue, which has seen the likes of titles being crowned, moments, returns, and special guests on the show like Hacksaw Jim Duggan and the like, and Pac was Beach Leisure Centre. I should correct myself there. So Aberdeen Anarchy is the WrestleMania for the Northeast. It piles in the biggest audience for WrestleZone more often than not. It has seen the likes of over 1,300 people come to Aberdeen Anarchy to see WrestleZone in action, whether it's to see the guests or to see just some wrestling in the Northeast. I can't wait. I've been going to Aberdeen Anarchy since 2013, so this will be 10 years since the first one I've been to. Of course, we didn't have one in 2021. And 2020, we did have one in 2022. I don't know. The pandemic really just ruined my brain for trying to remember what events. Didn't have one in 2020 and 2021. 2022 was the return. I'm there. So yeah, we've missed a couple of years, and then last year's was phenomenal in the Northern Hotel, and this looks like it's going to be exactly the same. It's going to be an amazing event, and I can't wait for it. It's sold out. It's sold out in advance, which shows how much people want to go and see this show. Whether it's want to see the main event, whether it's want to see a ladder match, whether it's want to see these guys some of the grudge matches, whether it's want to see Mr. WrestleZone. I don't know. I don't know your reasons for going. I know for me, this was a no-brainer. I was going to the show anyway. It doesn't matter if who's on the card, what's on the card. I'm going to see Aberdeen Anarchy. But to be able to see this card, see the shows, the matches that have been announced and confirmed and what we're leading to, the showdowns, it's well worth the ticket. It's well worth the price of admission alone to see some of these moments and matches. Because these are guys that, you're looking back now, but thinking back to that first show, Aberdeen Anarchy, that I saw in 2013. It was the 5th anniversary of WrestleZone. And when you think about who was on that card, there was Kaylee Ray, who you may know better as Alba Fire. Of course, there was Hacksaw Jim Duggan. There was Billy Gunn, of course, you've now seen AEW. There was such big names and such future names as well at that point. I didn't know who Bingo Balance was. I'd heard of Stevie Xavier, and then they had the first match on the main show of that in the Beach Ballroom, and it's forever down as one of my favorite matches and one of the best matches in WrestleZone history. Possibly I would see, as years have gone on, may have moved it into maybe third or something like that, but it remains as being one of the best matches in WrestleZone history, and you won't know it until you actually go to these shows and you'll see some of the best wrestling and best sports entertainment. You'll be sports entertained at these shows, I can guarantee it. So Aberdeen Anarchy has got a very close place to my heart as a WrestleZone fan, as a wrestling fan in general. And like I say, I can't sell you tickets because they're sold out. But if you have the opportunity to go to future WrestleZone shows, I'm hoping the passion I have to tell you about these shows and to give you a little bit of a preview of these moments and events, that you'll kind of be convinced if you see a show coming up near you in Aberdeen, or whether they go traveling to Ellen or wherever. I'm still holding up hope for like Keith. You can get a ticket and you can go and find out why I'm banging on about this and why I'm talking about it so much, and why I've dedicated a whole podcast to WrestleZone as well. You can find out when you buy a ticket and go to the show itself. Let's go through the whole card though. So we've got 7 matches on the pre-show. Let's start with the pre-show. Kicking off this preview is of course the pre-show match for Aberdeen Anarchy taking place this Saturday, May 13th. That was the last match announced. It is Oliver Green against Ted O'Keefe. So this is two guys that haven't been around WrestleZone an awful lot. Oliver Green made his in-ring debut at the Regal Rumble recently, just a couple months ago, back in March. And Ted O'Keefe hadn't been seen since about January 2022, I think it was Summer Hill Showdown. At that point, he kind of disappeared from the outfit and hadn't been seen since. And he made his return at Regal Rumble. We're thinking there might be some sort of showdown between him and Murphy and Dino. But it turned out it was all a ruse. The outfit is now a 3-man group. And we've got 2.5 men, depending on how you want to put it. We've got Ted O'Keefe and Oliver Green. So this is your VIP match. If you've bought your ticket, of course you have. It's sold out now. You're unable to buy more tickets or any more tickets at all. This is the one you're going to see, Oliver Green, Ted O'Keefe, when you get there. So doors open 5:30. If you get there in good time, you get your seat, you get your merch, see this match. And I think there's a VIP greet straight afterwards. So yeah, that's your first match pre-show. Let's get on to the main card. We're going to dive straight into the main show with this personal grudge match. It's Chris Archer versus Mickey Vago in a mosh pit rules. How did we get here? So the Rejected, former WrestleZone tag team champions multiple times. They were inseparable. They were the Hairy Bikers, the Outcasts, the Rejected, the Dogs of War, whatever you want to call them. They were a team. They've been a team for a long time in WrestleZone and very successful at that. And for whatever reason, Archer, I noticed it. People noticed it. The Archer was starting to look a little bit annoyed. A little bit surplused, I don't know if that's a real word, at the fact that Mickey Vago was able to capture the Tri-Counties Championship, the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship, a title that Archer won on the first show back when the pandemic had lifted and we were able to go see wrestling again at the Northern Hotel. Chris Archer defeated Captain Alan Sterling to win the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship in the main event of that show. And Vago came out, congratulated Archer. About a month later at Summer Hill Showdown, Captain Alan Sterling was able to regain that championship. He was able to regain the championship. And from that point onwards, okay, not a month later, but you know, shortly thereafter, he was able to regain the Tri-County Championship. And then Mickey Vago was able to lift the gold. He was able to become WrestleZone Tri-County Championship champion in Inverurie later that year. So he was able to weather the storm. He was able to do something that Chris Archer was able to do, and the Rejected were once again holding that WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship. He was able to defend it. Vago defended it in multi-man matches, triple threats with big guys. He defended it against like some Bruiser Brad and Dino. He was able to defend it in a four-way, in like a four pillars kind of situation with Ronan King, Rhys Dawkins, and Conor Malloy. He was able to defend it against Kilo Valhalla. He was able to defend it against a litany of opponents in WrestleZone until it came to Summer Hill Showdown. So the Summer Hill Showdown, well, I'm telling you everything here. The Summer Hill Showdown, we thought it was Zach Dynamite against Mickey Vago, the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship. We didn't know what was going to happen. Zach Dynamite is a former WrestleZone Tri-Counties Champion, 2-time, former Undisputed Champion as well. So he always had a good chance of winning. But Archer came out, chain wrapped in hand, and popped Mickey Vago in the face with that chain. And it led to Zach Dynamite picking up the pinfall and picking up the win and the title. Now, Archer, I was going to show you a footage in a little bit. He's not giving the explanation. He's not explaining to Mickey Vago what he's doing. Where was I? I got so impassioned there. Someone came out the door and was delivering an Amazon package. So yes, I don't know where I was. I'll find out when I go check the video footage later. We've had no explanation for Chris Archer. We don't know why. We don't know why he's doing this. Why he attacked Mickey Vago. Why he wants a piece of Mickey Vago. Vago doesn't know why. Vago doesn't really want to fight Chris Archer. But they're gonna. So, Trade Academy show came around. That's where we're kind of at a timeline. They were supposed to face off at the Regal Rumble, but due to illness, Chris Archer was unable to attend, so we didn't have the match. So it came down to the Training Academy show. Mickey Vago ended up in a match with Dino instead as a handpicked replacement. I was so unfit running up and down the stairs, I've realized on this. Wait a second. We're fine. Oh. I'm playing up a little bit. Don't worry about it. I'm not going to have a heart attack on this particular episode. Just wait until after. I'm doing the recap show instead. So, Chris Archer sent Dino in his place. And then we had Mickey Vago versus Dino. Which was a match, which was a match. It was interesting. It was different to what we were expecting, of course, because Dino being a monster in comparison to Chris Archer being a mental manipulative monster himself, sucking Vago in to only pop him in the face with a chain. It led to Training Academy show. Archer aggressive, more aggressive. He's now sport. He's no longer Archer Taker with the double denim. He's now got this Terry Funk like gear going on. He attacked Oliver Green, continued to attack Oliver Green after their match, and was looking to take him out of action permanently with a chair. But Mickey Vago made the save. Confrontation ensued. The match was on. It was agreed. Aberdeen Anarchy, Chris Archer, Mickey Vago. Led on to the evening show. I'm trying to remember these things. I could have them written down. Why would I do that? Why would I be prepared? Led on to the evening show. And Mickey Vago challenged Chris Archer to a mosh pit rules match. So, mosh pit rules, we've got to see that before. Weapons are legal. Vago's already taken on Ronan King in that particular style of match. We've seen things like drum kits, we've seen guitars, we've seen all these things used at the disposable. Weapons, instruments are legal, is pretty much the deal here. So this is Mickey Vago's specialty. If he's going to get Archer in the ring, if Archer wants a piece of him, he's going to do it on Vago's terms here, because Vago doesn't want this. He doesn't want this match. He doesn't want this match, but he's going to have to do it if he wants to find out why Chris Archer has done this. Will we find out Aberdeen Anarchy? Who knows? Maybe this will lead on to something down the line. Maybe this will be the start of something. This will be the first chapter in a feud of matches, a series of matches that escalate more and more as they go. We won't know. So let's have a look at Chris Archer's calling out video.
Mickey Vago, you were lucky. Lucky in the fact that Chris Archer was not at the Regal Rumble. I was out of it through illness. But you know what? You know what? It got me thinking. I had time to think. Enough is enough. I have one challenge for you, Vago. Aberdeen Anarchy. Chris Archer. Mickey Vago. One-on-one. Finally. What do you say, Vago? Too scared? Are you going to be brave enough to accept the challenge?
Now, the interesting thing about this match, we're still on Archer and Mickey Vago. I'm going to show you footage of their confrontation at the Training Academy show in a moment or two. That was the challenge that Chris Archer put out that you just saw or heard. Is that these guys are split even when it comes to Aberdeen Anarchy. So according to our research, I've got the results down. I did Control F. I found results I needed to. Archer is sitting at 4 wins, 4 losses in 8 matches at Aberdeen Anarchy. Mickey Vago is sitting on 3 wins, 3 losses in his 6 matches at Aberdeen Anarchy. So it's very interesting that they're both coming into this match with this very personal vendetta, this feud going on between the two, Chris Archer and Mickey Vago. But whoever wins pulls ahead and actually has a better win-loss record, Aberdeen Anarchy, you could say. I don't think that's something that's going to be playing onto their mind or something that's going to be important to them at all. They'll be looking just to either get answers or get revenge or get some sort of redemption or whoever you want to put it. It's very interesting that they're both kind of they're sitting even on their own Aberdeen Anarchy records. But that's just me. That's just me that likes that kind of statistics. But here is the conversation they had at the Training Academy show.
Tried, Archer. I really tried to avoid the situation we find ourselves in. But you had to keep pushing and keep pushing. So here we are. You got what you wanted. You got your one-on-one match at Aberdeen Anarchy. But here's the problem. It's under my rules. It's going to be under mosh pit rules. But before we bring this whole thing to an end, let's take a little walk down memory lane. You see, for over 8 years, Mickey Vago and Chris Archer, we stood together as the cornerstone of WrestleZone's tag team division. The Rejected, we were the standard bearers. We were the bar. Any team looking to be worth a damn in WrestleZone, whether it was Foundation of the Future or The Outfit or any other team that walked through those doors, they had to be able to hang with us first. But I wasn't Chris Archer's first tag team partner. Far from it. First there was Brian Starr when he was part of the Outcasts. Then he was in Revolution for a hot minute before Johnny Lyons and Damien kicked his arse out. Then he found some big muscle-headed freak to watch his back for a few months. But all of that came to nothing. Then January 2015 rolls around and Mickey Vago debuts as Chris Archer's new tag team partner. Now November of that same year, less than 12 months later, we were standing as WrestleZone Tag Team Champions. Titles we held on four separate occasions. Now I could sit here and argue that without me, Chris Archer would never have been a champion in WrestleZone. Even when he won the Tri-Counties Championship, it was with me standing in his corner when he won it. Whereas when I was Tri-Counties Champion, the only reason I lost that title is because Chris Archer stabbed me in the back. So Archer, if you want to throw away 8 years of history over jealousy or spite or whatever other reason you've got, that's fine. We can go to war. But as far as you burning the Rejected to the ground, I've got news for you. After Aberdeen Anarchy, when I beat you with candlesticks and guitars and whatever else I can find in the building that night. The rejected name is going to live on with me as I go into bigger and better things and more championships. Whereas you, Archer, Aberdeen Anarchy for you is going to be the end of the road.
An interesting one to speak about next up here. Got Captain Alan Sterling against a mystery opponent. We'll get into the reasons why and when right now. So at Regal Rumble, Aberdeen Anarchy title shot on the line. Captain Alan came out confronted by Caleb Valhalla. Of course, there's a lot of bad blood, a lot of revenge there, but a lot of stories that have yet to be finished or maybe completed. And then out came for the first time ever, debuting Deacon Matthews, the Cult of Positivity. He started out, him and Caleb had a little bit of a hello, and Deacon did Caleb's job for him and threw out Captain Alan Sterling from the Regal Rumble to a massive applause. So if you're wanting a guy, if Deacon's wanting to make some friends in WrestleZone straight away, throwing Captain Alan Sterling out of the Regal Rumble is one way to do it. So from there, at that point onwards, I'll show you footage in a second, Captain Alan had this to say.
You know what I heard earlier?
We are not listening. Yeah,
Continue listening. Anyway, I heard earlier Chris Archer challenging my opponent, Nicky Vega, for Aberdeen Anarchy. And I thought that sounded like a right good idea. Because you know who really annoyed me at Regal Rumble? Who really annoyed me? He had faces all over his wrestling trunks. His faces on the wrestling gear. That's just stupid.
Hey, you could like it was him. All your
the man that likes Deacon Blue. The man that eats Bernard Matthews. Yes, I'm talking about Deacon Matthews. God, I don't even know you, but I hate you.
Well, somebody wants to say something to him here.
Shut up. Aberdeen Anarchy, me and you, Deacon Matthews, bring your CDs, bring your turkey drumsticks, it's me and you, one on one, and I'm gonna beat you.
You can ask something.
Okay, I'm done now, shut up.
So I was at the Training Academy show. Unfortunately, after that challenge was put out, Deacon Matthews injured. I think he broke a rib. He's down on the shelf, but he did have something that he wanted to say about it. And Let's show you that first.
Ah! Hello, everybody! Deacon Matthews here, your disco dancing dude. Now, I believe a certain young mister, sorry, Captain Alan Sterling, has challenged me to a duel at Aberdeen Anarchy on May the 13th. Unfortunately, I've picked up a bit of a nasty rib injury that'll take me out for a month or two. I do apologise. However, I have lined up a mystery opponent for you, sir, so I do enjoy the surprise. But back to my first point. I have been looking on the interwebs at the Aberdeen Maritime records of captaincy qualifications, and I can't find you anywhere. Never mind, it's admin errors happen all the time. Anyway, I thought I'd go one step further and come down and see the ship itself, see this wonderful boat of yours that you talk about. Unfortunately, when I went to the docks, I met many a sailor, young and old, who know you really rather well, it turns out, but none of them seem to have heard of your boat. So that got me wondering, has this poor young man been cast adrift? Has he lost his ship? Well, I think I have a solution, sir. And when I'm that's sore, fit and healthy again, I have brought a present. You're in luck. You shall be a boatless captain no more. Yes, your very own ship. Ignore the water, it's fine. Okay, so when I'm well, I shall bring you this in person. In the meantime, enjoy your surprise at May the 13th at Aberdeen Anarchy. And good luck to everybody. Now I have to try and get out of this bath. Excuse me.
So Deacon Matthews there, he's got a little boat that he's going to give Captain Allen at some point in the future. But this is where the mystery lies. Captain Allen has an opponent. He doesn't know who his opponent is. We don't know who his opponent is. Deacon Matthews knows, though. And this is where the speculation lies. So I've got some ideas. I've got some ideas I want to throw out to you that might be that Captain Allen's opponent. Now, for a lot of WrestleZone fans, you might not be aware of where Deacon Matthews resided. He was mainly seen in Discovery Wrestling and also Reckless Intent Wrestling, who are currently on a hiatus. And when I'm thinking of Captain Allen, of course, with his toot-toot, with his boats, with his semen in tow, there's a few guys that I'm thinking could be the ones that come out. Could be totally wrong, though. You know me, my predictions when it comes to WrestleZone, I'm absolutely terrible at predicting anything that's going to happen at WrestleZone shows, because anything can happen at WrestleZone. But the first name that comes to my head is Rob Mills. This is a guy who's a bit of a pirate. He's a scurvy sea dog. He's a swashbuckler. And he's a guy that Rob Mills would probably have a bone to pick with Captain Allen, wanting to maybe plunder his boat, plunder his poop deck, and try and use Allen to cause nautical jokes, but he would want to try and come aboard Captain Allen's boat and take it for himself and cause a mutiny. I don't know. So Rob Mills comes to mind. A name that's popped around recently that I saw was Crusher Crabe, and that'd be very interesting because Crusher Crabe, of course, he retired last year at the Anarchy. We haven't heard anything from Crusher Crabe. We haven't seen anything from Crusher Crabe. He's quite happily retired, as far as I'm aware. Anyway, I don't stalk him or keep tabs, but he's been in the shadow. He's just be gone. He had his retirement moment. He had his speech. He wanted to leave it to the new guys, and he went off into the distance. He went into the background, and that was him done. But it'd be interesting, wouldn't it? Captain Allen and Crusher have got a little bit of history themselves as part of Sterling Oil. It'd be certainly an interesting scenario if Captain Allen has been confronted by someone from his past. Other names I'm trying to think of off my head here. So I said Rob Mills. There's a lot of guys that Deacon knows in places like Reckless Intent and Discovery. Theodorus, maybe Theodorus, but maybe make his way up to Aberdeen for Aberdeen Anarchy. Not impossible. Could be a thing that happens. So there's so many names out there that it could possibly be Scotty Swift. Why not? Why not? He's retired, but if the cause called for it, maybe we'll see Scotty Swift. But in my head, because Deacon Matthews is a little bit eccentric, he likes to have a little bit of fun, he likes to cause a little bit of a ruckus, I would put a couple pieces of silver on Rob Mills making an appearance at Aberdeen Anarchy. But, you know, we've seen people in the past that have come and gone, like Alistair Caron. You might see Alistair Caron come back. Of course, he appeared last year. And I'm saying, of course, again. I know who I am. I don't care. I'm enjoying this. I've enjoyed just speaking about Aberdeen Anarchy with you guys. Hopefully, if you're listening or watching. So that could be anything, really. It could be anyone. It could be Lee McAllister. It could be Sean Johnson. It could be Mr. P. It could be anyone out there. It could come out and confront Captain Allen Sterling, and that's what makes it very intriguing. Johnny Lyons, Jason Reed could come back. With Andy Roberts, who knows who could be making an appearance here. As far as stats go, if you like our stats in other matches, Captain Allen Sterling is sitting at 8 wins, 6 losses at Aberdeen Anarchy. Losses that included against Ross McTavish. It was an MMA rules match. It was certainly Mixed Martial Allen's moment of glory. Anyway, he's also, but he's picked up wins against the likes of Grado. So Alan at Aberdeen Anarchy is an interesting beast because he can pick up these massive wins. He can also have these kind of embarrassing losses at the same time. It's a very interesting dynamic for Captain Alan. He's a very capable wrestler, very entertaining wrestler, possibly a deluded wrestler at times, but he's always there to put on a show for better or for worse. He's always there to put on a show at Aberdeen Anarchy. So this is a very interesting one. I've shown you the footage for the build-up of this. I don't know what's going to happen. Like I said, I put a couple shillings on Rob Mills, but it could be anyone at the end of the day. If you want to throw in your guess, throw a comment below. Send me a comment, tweet me at Scott Resnett, and I want to know who you think could be Captain Alan Sterling's opponent. Could it be me? Who knows?
Brad, Ryan, lads, every single time you've talked about us, every single time you've ran your mouths, you've fired insults, tried to embarrass us. You've made this really personal, but we never wanted this to be personal.
You see, when we came to WrestleZone, we came here for two reasons. Number one was to become the WrestleZone Tag Team Champions. And number two is to prove that we are the best tag team in Scottish wrestling.
And I think with these belts around their waist, that proves it. So guys, if you want to jump us from behind, if you want to, as I said, embarrass us, then we'll happily repay the favour when we beat you twice in one night at Aberdeen Anarchy.
Saturday, the 13th of May at Aberdeen Anarchy. 2 out of 3 falls, we'll finally get to put the great debate to rest. Who is the best tag team in Scotland? The Foundation of the Future or the Fair City Saints?
Just heard the Fair City Saints there telling them that they telling his their opponents, Foundation of the Future, Bruiser Brad and Ryan Riley, that they're going to prove why they're the best. Got there eventually. I've already kind of talked about this in our previous episode with we was talking a little bit about the matches that were announced at the time for Aberdeen Anarchy. I can't wait for this. It's 2 out of 3 falls. Fair City Saints, the tag team champions of WrestleZone, against Bruiser Brad and Ryan Riley, the Foundation of the Future. 2 out of 3 falls. That will be a very interesting concept and possibly one of the best matches of the night. If you watched our recent episode with Caleb Valhalla and Aspen Faith over on the SWN podcast, we talked about the matches, this match itself, and Aspen very, very much thought this may steal the show, may open and may steal it straight away. They opened Regal Rumble and it was incredible. They had an incredible match at Christmas Chaos as well. They've had individual victories over each other, but the Fair City Saints seem to have Foundation of the Future's number when it comes to tag team competition, having defeated them the last two times they've faced off. Ryan Riley made the challenge at Regal Rumble saying that the Fair City Saints can't beat them twice in one night. And here we are, 2 out of 3 falls. I think there may be respect involved somewhere between Ryan and Brad and the Saints. There must be some sort of kind of you got us, you've got our number, but we're going to prove that we're still the Foundation of the Future. We're still the best, one of the best tag teams in the country, probably in the UK as well. And to have them face off in this 2 out of 3 falls where anything can happen, it could go 1-1. It could go 2-1, it could go 3, it could be a 2-0 wash. That's the thing. It could go to a third fall, might just be 2 falls that's needed. It makes everything interesting and exciting. Because if you're a team like Fair City Saints and these guys steamroll you in the opening couple of minutes, maybe you want to just get that first fall, maybe you want to just get that first fall tapped out and just give yourself a breather and stop the momentum that's going on from the Foundation of the Future. But then you've got to climb that ladder. You've got to climb a metaphorical ladder. You've got to climb that ladder to get 2 wins on the bounce. It makes things very... whoever wins this truly is one of the best tag teams. These two teams are the best tag teams in Scotland anyway. But to win this match and to prove to get 2 victories over your opponent one night in that time frame, really does prove that you're one of the premier teams. You've got the statistic to back it up, to say that yes, Fair City Saints are the best team in the country. They're one of the best teams in the country by far, but we're better. We beat them twice in one night. Fair City Saints can say, yeah, Foundation of the Future, amazing tag team, doing great things in Discovery, doing great things in Fair City. but we defeated them twice in one night, so we're the best team. There's more than just titles on the line here. There's bragging rights as well, and that's what makes it super, super intriguing to watch. Ryan Riley, Brad Evans, amazing team. They're getting bigger and better. They're broader. They're bullying. They're just bullies. They're just a formidable force. And this is what they're saying. Tell the Saints to be ready.
Well, Brad, once again, the two top teams in the country go head to head.
Go for a fight.
The Fair City Saints, the current WrestleZone Tag Team Champions, and the foundation of the future. And I guess we're just really going to prove who are the best tag team in the country. You know, they took those championships from us in Danestone Community Centre.
Yeah, they did.
And we're coming back there to take them back from you.
You see, boys, we found out who the weakest link is in your team. And that is Alex Webb.
Why is it Webb?
Because I beat him.
You beat him, didn't you?
I beat him. Sure. 1, 2, 3.
So, boys, you best be ready.
Be ready, boys.
No tag team in the planet is beating us twice in one night.
No chance.
Be prepared, boys.
Be prepared.
Be inspired.
Yes.
And for those stat nerds out there, I can let you know that out of this 2 out of 3 falls match, the records are for Aberdeen Anarchy. Alex Webb never had a match at Aberdeen Anarchy, so it's 0-0. So he's never lost. He's technically undefeated. He's never had a match. Air Miles sitting at 1-0. Last year, he was in the pre-show match, defeating Alistair Caron. Foundation of the Future, bruiser Brad Evans is sitting 2-2, 2 wins, 2 losses. And Ryan Riley, 1 win from last year and 2 losses. So they've got, they're not like big records, I suppose, when it comes to their win-loss records, when it comes to Aberdeen Anarchy. But they're obviously looking to get another win in those columns for Brad to get that weighted back into the win favour, 3-2, Ryan to try and catch up to his loss record. This is a big chance for Alex and Air Miles as well, making their main card debuts. Alex Webb making his debut on Aberdeen Anarchy entirely. So there's a lot going on going into this match, and it's going to be one of the standout matches of the weekend. Time now to look at another tag team match on the show on Aberdeen Anarchy on May 13th. We've got it's an interesting one. Let's dive in. We've got the team of Brian Tucker and Reese Dawkins. They have an amazing name that I've just dropped off the top of my head. Wrestlers against low-life entities, or I know entities is not right, but I know that is the gist of the name of their tag team. They're up in a skate. Just trying to get all that out of my mouth has just went all over the place. Anyway, Tucker and Dawkins. This is going well, and we're keeping it in. Tucker and Dawkins will be taking on the team of Omar Muhammad and Mr. WrestleZone. So this is a brand new team. I don't think they've teamed before, from my records, from my recollections. Anyway, Omar Muhammad has a massive beef with Tucker and Dawkins. I'm just reading Tucker so I don't get that wrong again. So Brian Tucker and Reese Dawkins, of course, they are the reason why Scotty Swift, one of Omar's closest confidants and friends in WrestleZone, is no longer in WrestleZone after the events of Christmas Chaos, when Reese Dawkins used his big book of Shakespeare to knock out Scotty Swift, which led to Brian Tucker pinning Scotty and leaving WrestleZone because of it, because of the conclusion of the match. That obviously moved on to Station Hotel Showdown when Scotty Swift appeared in the crowd as a fan, but had a ticket, was in the crowd, was speaking to Jonathan, and got to speak to everyone in the crowd as well. But confrontation happened during a handicap match. Omar Muhammad was taking on Dawkins and Tucker, and it led to Scotty leaving the venue after having a bit of a push with Brian Tucker. Revealing his snazzy Wally t-shirt as well, which was, classic Wally Tucker. So we had that, and of course, you've got the, of course, the meter going, Mr. WrestleZone made his debut at Regal Rumble. I'm a bit flustered thinking about this match, because we don't know a lot about Mr. WrestleZone. He's had his debut match. He had at the Training Academy show, but there's still a lot of questions about the identity of Mr. WrestleZone. We watched the Caleb versus Aspen recent interview that we did on Scottish Wrestling Network. Aspen's got his theories that he's a six-year-old child that's got a giganticism. Some people are even saying it's Scotty Swift, even though that's not the case. There's been other theories, Jimbo Bannon maybe, some returning, maybe it's Sisto and other new guys. We don't know. Maybe it's one of the Millistos. We have no idea who Mr. WrestleZone is and where that mystery has drove Tawkins. Tawkins, that's what you're called now. Tawkins, that's just your joint name, like Brangelina. It's just driven Dawkins and Tucker mad. They think it's Scotty Swift. It's not proven. We don't know it is. So this has led to Mr. WrestleZone and Omar Mohammed taking on Brian Tucker and Rhys Dawkins in this tag team match. We'll look at the footage in a moment. Brian Tucker put out the plan, put out the challenge. Let's check that out.
Brian, I'm so sorry about what happened at the Academy show, but Mr. WrestleZone, he just got under my skin and I just,
look,
I just couldn't handle it.
Look, Rhys, I don't need to hear that now. I've got a plan. I've been away and I've concocted the greatest plan in history.
Okay.
We're going to find out who Mr. WrestleZone truly is.
How do you plan to do that?
Since we've been tag teaming, we've proven ourselves to be quite the team.
Absolutely. We're excellent, excellent tag team competitors.
So how about this? Aberdeen Anarchy. Mr. WrestleZone.
Whomever that may be.
I know who it is. And Omar Mohammed versus us.
That's an excellent idea. May 13th at the Danestone Community Centre. How can we possibly be defeated?
You know what? This is the plan. This is the plan that's going to work. And we're going to prove to the world that Mr. WrestleZone is Scotty.
No, don't worry about that now, Brian. Tell you what, let's close the book on this chapter and move on to brighter and better things.
And it wasn't long before Mr. WrestleZone accepted that challenge on the behalf of his team. And that's it. That's the match set. We've got Mr. WrestleZone and Omar Mohammed teaming up for the first time ever. I'm hoping that Omar has a Shivani in mind. Hopefully he got the Shivani back that was lifted, was politely borrowed by Mr. WrestleZone for the Training Academy show. And we'll get a fantastic, sensational entrance with the two. Mr. Mohammed and Mr. WrestleZone. Why not? Let's call him that. So we've got that against Brian and Tucker and Rhys Dawkins. I can't wait for this. This is a lot of fun. We're going to see. Let's just check Mr. WrestleZone accepting the challenge on behalf of his team. And then we'll skip on to the next match.
Right, Oliver, where is he?
I'm not too sure.
Did you see the message?
I did.
He must have got the
He's not going to choke. What is that?
What are you doing? No. Oh, for God's sake.
That's right. If you bought a ticket to see Aberdeen Anarchy versus one, if you bought a ticket to see Aberdeen Anarchy, you're going to see Mr. WrestleZone in a ladder match.
We're not in a ladder match.
Oh, my goodness. Can you believe it's a real thing?
Get down.
What?
We're not in the ladder match. You're not in the ladder match. We're in a tag match.
A tag match?
Yes, against Dawkins and Tucker. Oh, come on. You saw.
You accepted it.
Did you not see the video?
You accepted it! You could have said, boop, 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 boop. Oh, hello! Oh, hi! Hi, Mr. Mohammed! Sure, I'll be in a tag team match, that's fine, I'll be on, okay? You could have said...
I'm sorry, do you want to accept it now?
Mr. Rhys Dawkins and Mr. Brian Tucker, they believe that Scotty Swift and Mr. WrestleZone are the same person. Here's the reasons why you're wrong. One! Scotty Swift does not wear a mask. Two, Scotty Swift has never been banned from Aster Gertie for expressing himself in a visual manner. And three, he has never hit Mr. Ronan King with a Styles Clash at a seven-year-old birthday party.
Okay, can you take this seriously? Okay? It's Aberdeen Anarchy, the biggest show of the year. Take it seriously!
Ah! Mr. Cameraman!
There we go!
No, man! We're talking about Aberdeen Anarchy! We're talking about a real sensational champion! We're talking about someone who would like to be a champion one day! And we're going to go to Aberdeen Anarchy!
Yeah, Baba!
We're going to make of them a humble!
Yeah!
Humble!
Aberdeen Anarchy!
It's getting sensational!
We're going to Anarchy!
And of course, for all you stat lovers out there, I'm not forgetting. I'm not totally recording them straight afterwards, thinking, oh no, I forgot to actually put the stats on Aberdeen Anarchy records here. But I've got them in front of me. Where are they in my notes, my Rolodex of notes? Here we are. Mr. WrestleZone, of course, sitting on 0 wins, 0 losses, being his first debut in Aberdeen Anarchy after he made his WrestleZone debut at the Regal Rumble. So he hasn't got a record yet on Aberdeen Anarchy. Omar Mohamed sitting in 0-1. He made his debut last year at Aberdeen Anarchy at the Northern Hotel in that six-man tag team match, which saw the Sterling brothers picking up the win and were unable to... So Lee McAllister was obviously supposed to be his tag team partner with Scotty Swift, but Lee McAllister was injured. And sorry, not Sterling brothers. My word, my research is going terrible. It's, of course, William Sterling and the outfit that caused the loss for Omar Mohamed last year at Aberdeen Anarchy when they defeated team of Scotty Swift, Omar, and Johnny Lyons. The one night only return of Johnny Lyons. So sitting at 0-1, just looking to get that, hopefully get that cancelled out, the victory here on May 13th. Rhys Dawkins made his debut last year at Aberdeen Anarchy, a first match and a win on the pre-show against Blue Thunder. There was a little bit of controversy in that match involving an exposed turnbuckle, but the records show Rhys Dawkins is undefeated at Aberdeen Anarchy, which is always a good thing to come into Aberdeen Anarchy with, an undefeated streak. Brian Tucker sitting at 4 wins, 7 losses. There's quite some heavy losses in that time, including losing the Undisputed Championship to Johnny Lyons, but also some victories as well. Of course, ousting Sterling Oil at one point in his record at Aberdeen Anarchy. So there's some big matches, big moments that Brian Tucker's had in Aberdeen Anarchy. And this one might not be as grandioso for a championship, but I think this is going to be one of the most entertaining matches of the night, for sure. One of the most interesting matches on the night, most intriguing, because you didn't see this one coming, was the six-person ladder match for a future title opportunity. This is a very odd match, but we'll go through who's in it and just. Yeah, let's talk about it. Let's talk about it. So we've got Conor Malloy, of course, one of the standouts in WrestleZone right now. He's been putting in fantastic matches. He may not be getting the results his way, but he's certainly putting in the effort in the matches that make you want to see Conor Malloy more. And this is seeing him in this match absolutely makes sense. Tommy Raiden, who he's got a promo video that we'll put in a little bit. I don't know how I'm going to do this because I've got a couple to throw in there, so I might just go, this is his. Actually, that's what we'll do. So Tommy Raiden's in this one. First Aberdeen Anarchy, made his debut last year. Very big opportunity considering that for a lot of new guys in WrestleZone, when they come in, they usually in the pre-show of Aberdeen Anarchy, but he's well in right now in this main card show, and it's going to be a big one because ladder match, future title opportunity. He got a victory recently over Murphy at the Training Academy show, so he's been in the ring with some big opponents, big matches against guys that are a lot bigger than him. And this is not only in a match with a lot of big guys, but a lot of experienced individuals as well. But is the risk going to be worth the reward? Of course, because you get a title opportunity at the end of it. So let's have a look what he has to say, and we'll have a look at the rest of the entrance as well.
You see, there's this old saying that kept haunting me for a couple of weeks. That saying being, there's a first time for everything. You see, my first Aberdeen Anarchy show, WrestleZone decided to put on their first ever ladder match for the Tag Team Championships. And now, 9 years later, the ladder match is coming back. It's gonna be me, the lightning bolt, Tommy Raiden, going up against 5 of WrestleZone's best. You've got the outfit with Dino and Murphy. You've got William Sterling. You've got the Tri-Counties champion himself, Zach Dynamite, and Conor Malloy. Now, I can't really make guarantees with a ladder match. This is the biggest opportunity that there is for the lightning bolt. Can't make any guarantees. So all I can say is this, ladies and gentlemen, May 13th, Danestone Community Centre, get ready for the ladder match. Because I'm Tommy Raiden, and I am Lightning.
Along with Connor and Tommy, we've also got a massive tag team. We've got Dino and Murphy, the outfit. Ted O'Keefe, nowhere to be seen at this moment in time when he was returned back at Regal Rumble. So you would assume that these two guys would be looking to help each other to gain this title opportunity and would be going for the tag team titles. But it is an individual that has to win in the end. It's an individual that's going to win. And they may see this tag team opportunity that they're going for. That might be the agreement pre-match. But there's always going to be that temptation. If you win a future title shot in a ladder match, it doesn't mean you have to go for the tag titles. We could see Dino. He's had his opportunities. He's had his matches against the Undisputed Heavyweight Champion, whether it was Damien. Had a match with Damien recently. That was last year, not even recently. It was a non-title match, but he put in such an effort that you couldn't unconceivably see Dino. That was a double negative. But you can see Dino in the heavyweight title picture. You can see either of these guys in the tri-county title picture, or we can see them in the tag title picture. So to see the outfit going into this match, where every man would be for themselves, and speaking of someone else that will be in the forefront of their mind as well in this match, it's just very interesting to see Dino and Murphy in a free-for-all like this future title shot ladder match. Whether this is going to be something that'll end up being a staple in Aberdeen Anarchy in the future, maybe we'll see this is going to be like their money in the bank kind of thing. It'll be interesting, definitely interesting. So speaking of someone I said would be very interesting, I'll show their promo in a second, is William Sterling in this match. William Sterling, of course, he's famed for his wild ladder match antics, being one of the only guys in this match with ladder match experience. But he's got a mission. He's got a mission himself. Let's have a look, see what he's got to say.
You see, I've just been back from the doctor because there are problems in my life, you see. Every time I'm in a ladder match, I seem to go a bit crazy. Once again, for the third time, I'm in a ladder match. And guys, what you don't understand is I have the experience. I know exactly what to do in this match. And now I may be the end. I might have more years behind me than forward, but what an opportunity for William Sterling to win this match and for the first time ever lift singles gold. So whether it be the outfit, whether it be Zach Dynamite, Conor Malloy, Tommy Raiden, you look me in the eyes. You are looking at the winner of the ladder match. This year, William Sterling, he is finally going to lift singles gold.
So he's wanting a singles title gold. Of course, one of the most decorated tag team wrestlers in Scottish wrestling, and definitely in WrestleZone. He's wanting to get that singles title for the first time. And, you know, we don't see William Sterling often. To be honest, he's a little bit different than he was way back when. He's not as mobile, but he's, again, much like I was talking about Tommy Raiden, he's weighing up the high risk, high reward factor. And if he has to throw himself a bit more into some ladders, but he gets a singles title opportunity at the end of it, will it be worth it? Will it be worth the pain on his hips? Will it be worth the pain on his back? Will it be worth all that pain in order to get the ultimate goal, the ultimate prize, being a title that he's never won in WrestleZone, and being a star so long in WrestleZone? He's been there since day one. And again, with that ladder match experience as well, there's a lot of going in William Sterling's favor. But we were speaking about ladder match experience. There's one other person that does have experience in ladder matches, and he's the guy that I don't know if he's going to be the favorite. He's definitely got all the attributes to be the favorite. Whether he's got the motivation to be the favorite, that's the big question. The last man in this match, if you're not watching on the video, it's current WrestleZone tag team, WrestleZone Tri-Counties champion, it's Zach Dynamite. Here's what he's got to say.
Climbing the ladder of success is something everyone around here wants to do. in Aberdeen Anarchy this year, it's very much a possibility. Six men enter a ladder match for a shot at any title they want. But out of those six men, only one man has been the undisputed champion. Only one man has sat atop of WrestleZone as kingpin. And that's me. You see, this ladder match, winning this ladder match, is my only way back to the undisputed championship. So I'm going to take it. At Aberdeen Anarchy this year, I will climb the ladder of success. And once again, I will sit atop WrestleZone as its kingpin.
So it was brought up in the Caleb and Aspen chat that we've had recently on SWN. Is Zach Dynamite going to be 100% motivated to win this? He's already got a championship. He's already been in the main event of Aberdeen Anarchy. He's won the main event of Aberdeen Anarchy. He's the co-winner of Regal Rumble in 2022. He's got all these accolades, and he's been through hell. He's done the Halloween brawls. He's done the death-defying antics in WrestleZone. And to be honest, he could probably walk into a title opportunity anytime he wished. So why would he want to put his body at risk in this particular match to get a title opportunity, which he could conceivably, with the Foundation of the Future beside him, conceivably bully his way into any time he wants? So that's where that interest lies, because we've seen if Zach Dynamite isn't 100% motivated or focused into a match, he'll just leave. He won't be there until the bitter end. So it's just, who will win? That's your thought here. It's there's so many factors here. Like I say, Dino and Murphy tag team, you think they'd be working together to be go for a tag title shot. They've also had that alliance recently with William Sterling, who's definitely going for a singles title opportunity. He's made a lot of risks during ladder matches in Aberdeen Anarchy in WrestleZone history. So you've got to think it has to pay off at some point. You've got Tommy Raiden, who's very fresh face, less than a year in WrestleZone and already in a featured match on Aberdeen Anarchy, which is a huge opportunity. And he's been a bit of a giant killer already. Speaking of giant killers, you got Conor Malloy, who's been a bit floating. He's been floating since Crusher Crabe retired last year at Aberdeen Anarchy at Northern Hotel. So, and then Zach Dynamite, the current Tri-Counties champion, having all the accolades and attributes to win, but has he got the motivation to do it? Personally, it's got to be Conor Malloy. That's my gut. My gut is saying Conor Malloy is winning this six-way ladder match for the title opportunity, and I want to see him and Aspen Faith or Caleb Valhalla or even just Conor and Zach Dynamite duking out over a title. I think that would be a really great way to go into the summer and see this feud. And that would be my gut. But you know, like I said, I've always said my predictions for WrestleZone are the worst, absolute worst. So sorry, Connor. I think I may have just put the final nail in your coffin of thinking you're winning. But that's just the way I would like to see, what I want to see. So it's not necessarily what we will see. But in any event, this is going to be possibly a car crash, but you're not going to be able to take your eyes off this particular match. It's going to be something. It's going to be a spectacle at Danestone Community Centre for Aberdeen Anarchy. It's going to be the anarchy in Aberdeen Anarchy. And for you stat fans out here, here is the layout of the land when it comes to this particular match, the six-way future title shot ladder match. Zach Dynamite, of course, he's got 4 wins, 3 losses, one of them being a ladder match, one of those losses in the Tri-Counties Championship when they debuted the title. Dino is sitting at 2-1, so 2 wins, 1 loss. Murphy with 1 win, being last year's 6-person tag team match. Tommy Raiden making his debut, 0-0. Conor Malloy with 1 loss, he made his debut last year, losing in the opening tag team title match, which saw Crusher Gray retire after the bout when they lost to the Foundation of the Future. And William Sterling sitting at a very interesting 7 wins, 7 losses. So is he going to be adding to one column or the other and out and doing the unbalance there? Or that's gonna be very interesting to see William Sterling coming in for his 15th. So he's been at every Aberdeen Anarchy, am I right in thinking that? has been every Aberdeen Anarchy. He's now sitting at 7 wins, 7 losses. This is me just doing a control F on all the results that I've gathered through Aberdeen Anarchy history. So I could be absolutely wrong, and William Sterling is definitely the kind of person that will contact me to correct that. But yeah, so that's what we're looking at there. Future title opportunity ladder match. There's your stats for everyone who is, of course, doing the bookies and doing your odds on the particular match. And in the penultimate match we're looking at here for Aberdeen Anarchy, I noticed that my camera's going a bit odd here. I've got a green line. Hopefully it's not impeding your viewing of my face. I've now just got a green streak down there. We're looking at the penultimate match on the show, which is Ronan King taking on Damien. This is personal. This is a personal feud, grudge match going on. We've got other grudge matches on this show. This is also one of them. Ronan King came out at Station Hotel Showdown to confront injured Damien. Damien had pulled a hamstring or torn a hamstring and was recovering. He was doing the raffle. Standard behavior. If you're injured in WrestleZone, you get to do the raffle, which I don't know if that's something that's a perk of being injured in WrestleZone, I suppose. So he was doing the raffle, doing very well, former Undisputed WrestleZone champion. He's seen a few raffles in his time. Ronan King came out, I think it was his third appearance of that show. He was in the pre-show match. He was fill-in as well in the tag title match. And then this is his third appearance. I said that pretty much Damien was going to be a stepping stone. A little bit of confrontation. Ronan kicked Damien in his injured leg. Kicked his leg out of his leg. And there we go. It was on. That was pretty much the catalyst for all this. Came to Regal Rumble time. The match was announced. Ronan King versus Damien. Ronan didn't want to give Damien a match. He gave him a 10-minute challenge because he didn't think that Damien could go to beat Ronan within 10 minutes. Damien survived the challenge and they went on to the Rumble itself. In the Rumble, Damien was one of the final four, but beforehand, Ronan King came out. He was the final entrant, but Chris Archer pulled out because of illness. So he was number 19. I think that was how many entrants there were this year. So he was last entrant anyway. He came out with his glasses on. And after a little bit of postulating, Damien pretty much threw him out instantaneously. So he was out. And that was him out of the Rumble, which was a shame. I do like watching Ronan wrestle, but, you make your bed kind of thing. He's made his bed and Damien threw him back into it. Ronan came back out towards the end and confronted not only Damien. Ronan King came out towards the end, not only confronted Damien, but also confronted Damien's daughter, who's a staple in the crowd at WrestleZone. And it was enough of a distraction for Damien to be eliminated as he was in the final four of the Regal Rumble, along with Bruiser Brad, Ryan Riley, and Caleb Valhalla. So there's a lot of... Ronan King, 19-year-old. Talented, so very talented, arrogant, so very arrogant, and he's looking to use Damien, a record-holding undisputed WrestleZone tag WrestleZone champion, former tag team champion also, and we've got a question coming up about Mount Rushmore of WrestleZone. Damien's got a very good accolade list and tenure in WrestleZone to earn a spot on there. And he's being used as a stepping stone for Ronan King, which, if there's anyone you want to try and take on to try move on to the next level, Damien's probably your guy you want to go for. But Damien's not done yet. He's been around WrestleZone for a very long time, possibly from the inception, definitely, for a very long time. And he's not a guy that's just going to roll over and let someone use him to move ahead. You got to earn it. You got to earn that accolade. You got to earn your match, your flowers. That seems to be the phrase nowadays. So this was going to be really fun because that 10-minute preview we got at the Regal Rumble, a lot of good stuff going on, really great match. But we didn't see everything that Damien could give or everything that Ronan could give because Damien was there just to survive the 10 minutes. That's all he was needing to do. Whereas Ronan, even though he was being cocky, he was also not giving his full. He was underestimating. That's probably the best word. Underestimating Damien. So This must make it interesting. These are all the matches on the show. There's full of intrigue, full of interest on how each are going to combat in this particular match. So possibly another possible show stealer. This could be another match that will steal the weekend on May 13th. This is going to be a good one. Ronan King sitting undefeated on Aberdeen Anarchy shows. He won last year against Mickey Vago. Hopefully the crowd is safe this year and they're not going to get thrown weapons at like they were at Aberdeen Anarchy last year. Damien's sitting on a record of 8 wins, 8 losses. But some of those wins have been big wins, including undisputed title wins, undisputed title retentions. He's built up an Aberdeen Anarchy win-loss record. It says 8-8, but in those 8 wins and 8 losses, there have been some amazing moments that he's created at Aberdeen Anarchy. This is an event that Damien, he's competed in steel cage matches at this event. Some barbaric triple threats. He's defended his Wrestling Undisputed Championship. I'm lying when I say that. He has won the Undisputed Championship, I think twice. He beat Sean Johnson, and he also won it in 2019 as well at the Beach Leisure Centre. He, if I remember rightly, again, off the top of my head here, the Undisputed Championship was created at Aberdeen Anarchy when Damien defeated Scotty Swift for the No Limits and Heavyweight titles to be merged. So Aberdeen Anarchy is Damien's playground, and Ronan is stepping into Damien's playground to try and like I say, use Damien, which, you know, it might not end well for him, but if anyone's got the confidence to do so, it's definitely Ronan King.
Aspen, we have fought side by side. We have fought across all the realms. We have fought through the streets, and we have fought through space and time. And now the Granite Road leads us to Aberdeen Anarchy. A chance at immortality. The Undisputed Championship and two unstoppable forces ready to collide. At the Regal Rumble, you asked, who is worthy? And now, at Aberdeen Anarchy, you ask, who is the better man? Well, the mighty Caleb is no ordinary man. So bring everything you have, and let's become immortal together. Skull! Skull! Skull!
Now we've got to talk about the big one. The main event of Aberdeen Anarchy 2023, the Regal Rumble winner, Caleb Valhalla, taking on the undisputed WrestleZone champion, Aspen Faith. Now, it's been said, and I've got footage of Aspen saying so for his promo, and this isn't a rivalry. This is two of the elite in Scotland, WrestleZone in Scotland. These are the elite going at it for the biggest prize in the Northeast. That's it. That's what you're paying your money to see. It's two big guys, big horses fighting to win the Undisputed Wrestling Championship. There's no like, Aspen's jealous of Caleb. Caleb's jealous of Aspen. No, this is a fight. This is your marquee match. This is your main event. And it's going to be a main event that will be, unlike many WrestleZone events, main events that have happened at Anarchy in the past. There's no animosity. There's no out for revenge. It's simply two of the best wrestlers in the company wrestling in the main event of Aberdeen Anarchy. And this will split the crowd. This will absolutely 100% split the crowd. I mean, it's split my household. My wife is a huge fan of Caleb Valhalla. He's her favorite wrestler in Scotland, is definitely in WrestleZone. And myself, my favorite wrestler is Aspen, and probably Caleb second. So we're going to be split, divided in this household. I can't imagine what people in the crowd's going to be as well, because that's it. It's two of the best. And I can't understate that enough. Caleb's, this is his first main show Aberdeen Anarchy match. He was in the pre-show in 2019, where he won a four-way, including Irving Garrett, Tiger, and Kaden Garrick. He didn't have a match at 2022 because Captain Alan Sterling was ill. He was unable to attend. And so this is his first main show match, Aberdeen Anarchy main event. And yeah, like I say, he's in the main event. He came through injury. I think it was a torn tricep. I could be totally wrong. I apologize. But he had an injury coming into the Regal Rumble. He had a match earlier that night as well. It was a six-man tag. And he came into the Rumble and he killed Mr. Malice for the who knows how many times when he threw them off the top rope out of the ring. He did that, and then he was in the final four with Damien, the two guys from the Foundation, Brad and Ryan, and it came down to Caleb fighting off Brad and Ryan. And he was able to win. He was able to get Brad over the top rope to finish the match. And there's a feel-good aspect to Caleb winning, because Caleb's a guy that made his debut in WrestleZone. He's wrestled across the country now. He's been down in Glasgow. He's been down in Perth. He's been wrestling all over the country. And to see his development from just being Captain Allen's muscle to this Viking mighty god that's coming up to the Northeast to wrestle, it's remarkable and it's wonderful to see. See Aspen, a guy, again, from the WrestleZone Training Academy. He is wrestled in the UK, all over the place, in everything, death matches, steel cages, ladder matches. He's the guy that is the first and currently only Grand Slam champion in WrestleZone, winning the tag team titles, the Tri-Counts Championship, and the Undisputed Championship, which he won at Christmas Chaos. Along with being a co-winner of the Regal Rumble, he's won everything you can win in WrestleZone. And he's coming into this match just to cement his legacy in WrestleZone, because this is a guy who had a lengthy break in WrestleZone. He was wrestling around the country. And when he came back at Summer Hill Showdown in 2022, the place exploded. It was electric. They were so happy to see Aspen back, because he's their hometown guy. He's not changed anything he does. He's not embracing the fans. He's still Aspen Faith. He's still Lost by Aspen. He's still the guy that will just batter opponents and look cool doing it. And the fans have just gravitated towards him to embrace him, whether he likes it or not. So this is going to be your emotional main event. I mean, this year is one of the first years. Last year didn't have import, quote unquote import, but this year it doesn't have it. But it feels bigger because you have that main event of two guys from the Wrestling Training Academy, two of the best in the country right now, pound for pound certainly. And they're having this match just for the title. It's just a title match. It's Regal Rumble winner against Undisputed Champion. There's no animosity. This is two guys that they would probably consider themselves friends as well. They've tag teamed elsewhere. They fought elsewhere as well. And they're doing it in the main event of the show. And like I say, I can't understate the importance of this match, not only for just me as a fan, but also as an advertisement for the WrestleZone Training Academy, because these are two guys. Probably there's so many guys that have come through the WrestleZone Training Academy, but these two are just phenomenal. So I mean, there's other guys, of course. Zach Dynamite's come through the WrestleZone Training Academy. Chris Archer, Mickey Vago. They've produced so many polished talents right now that are coming through and are still going through and still wrestling. And are wrestling elsewhere as well. But this main event really gives testament to the WrestleZone Training Academy. And this main event is going to be off the hook. It's going to be a just knockdown, drag out, barbaric. There's going to be a lot of big meaty men slapping meat. It's going to be a main event for the ages. And I hope I'm not hyping it up too much, but I bought my ticket as soon as Caleb won the Regal Rumble, because I knew this was going to be the main event. This is the main event I wanted to see. This is the main event I wanted to see as soon as Aspen won the title at Christmas Chaos. I was all in on Caleb outlasting everyone and winning the Regal Rumble. So, like I say, you can't buy a ticket. It's sold out. But hopefully, by watching this and listening to this, you're going to be even more hyped for the main event. because it's going to be epic. It will be. It just will be. So that's it. That's all the matches. Let's have a look at some of the questions that we've got coming in.
Aberdeen Anarchy is the biggest show of the year, and this is the biggest main event that WrestleZone could have even conceived to put on. And anyone who's going to question that, because I know that's going to happen, tickets were 80% sold out just off the back of this match. Tickets are completely sold out more than 2 weeks before the show is meant to happen. So don't come at me when I say that this is the biggest match of the year. Now, Caleb, I don't have a problem with you. I think that's pretty obvious. We're friends. You happen to have won the Regal Rumble, and it's me versus you at Anarchy. So anyone who thinks that there's going to be any sort of underhanded tactics or anything like that, just put that out of your mind. This is a match. This is a fight. We're going to both go into Aberdeen Anarchy. We're going to walk the granite road, and we are going to fight till victory. And whoever comes out at the end of the night with the WrestleZone Undisputed Championship, they're the better man.
And while my camera is still alive, that was Aspen Faith's thought on his match in the main event of Aberdeen Anarchy, a match, as I've said, I'm so excited to see, so excited for this show. I love going to these shows when I can, really. I haven't missed that many in the last 2 years since shows came back at the end of 2021. Let's get some questions. That's what we're going to do now. So, Aberdeen Anarchy, May 13th, Danestone Community Centre. If you've got your ticket, ace. If you haven't, well, you can't get in. It's sold out. I hope my preview of the show and seeing the footage and the promos that have been done for the show get you in the mood for WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy. If it hasn't, then I don't know what to tell you. If you've got your ticket and you're not excited, then I don't know what to tell you. That's pretty much what the be-all and end-all is there. Let's get some questions. We do have Callum sent in a bunch of questions. Thank you very much, Callum, for doing so. We're just going to crack on through them. Which previous Aberdeen Anarchy matches should get a repeat? I mean, I wouldn't be against seeing Grado Scott Hoyt again, of course, but that's just personal bias. Of course, I mean, you see these guys, the imports in Neville versus, Pac versus Zach Dynamite. I would watch again, a heartbeat. Thinking of matches that I want to see again from, like, not including the guests making an appearance. I mean, if we're just throwing out anything out there, I would love to see Piper Niven and Emerson Jane go at it again, because why not? What else? There's just so many. I mean, again, wouldn't say no to Crusher Crabe Scotty Swift again, because that match ended abruptly because of an injury to Crusher Crabe, so I wouldn't mind seeing that go back. They did have other matches, of course, because they had a big feud, big feud later, a couple of years down the line. So, you know what? There's so many that happened that they were in the moment. Crusher Crabe versus Jack Jester, one of my favorite matches from Aberdeen Anarchy history. I would love to see that again. I'd love to see ones that over the Tri-Counties Championship, that four-way ladder match. Absolutely, we'd love to see it again. We've been lucky. We're definitely lucky. I'm gonna pull up the matches that have happened at Aberdeen Anarchy. See if just any that pop into mind that I'd just like to see go back as they are now. So, like, not revisiting that year and just seeing the match happen again with them, like, all grown up. So, like I said, we've had Piper Niven versus Emerson Jane. That pre-show battle royal from 2018, I would absolutely love to see that again. That was Jason Reed, Lord Michael of Graham, Bradley Evans, Ryan Riley, Dino Del Monte, Ted O'Keefe, and Caden Garrick. That would be very interesting now, seeing where Brad's gone, where Jason has gone, Dino and the like. That would be very interesting to go back and see. Of course, I would always love to see Captain Allen against Grado. That would be ace. Let's move back a little bit to 2017. Let's see what we've got there. Johnny Lyons, Damien, that can never go wrong. We had Swoggle versus Luke King Sharp. I would happily see that again. There's so many. Let's see, 2016. I'm sure Mickey Vega would love to get his hands on Bull James once again. I still have Scotty Swift versus Crusher Crabe. 2015, Jack Jester, Brian Tucker. That would be definitely interesting now, considering where they've gone from there. With Jack Jester, Big Kink, and against Wally Tucker. 2014 was my favorite event ever. I think possibly my favorite WrestleZone event. We had like Zach Dynamite, James Midas in the pre-show. Yes, let's have that back. I would love to see that again. What else we got? Damien Zach Dynamite, we saw a few times. That was from 2013. Big Ol' Balance, Stevie Xavier. We did see it happen a second time. I'm not against seeing that third. Seeing it one more time. Why not? I've had the likes of Kenny Williams, Sean Johnson. Was it Kenny Williams, Sean Johnson, and Bingo Balance? That was 2015. Why not? Let's see that again. Yeah, we've been spoiled. We've been spoiled the last few years for WrestleZone, the last 10 years at the very least. We could just have a bit anything. Yeah, just give me wrestling. More wrestling. Who has the best entrance music in WrestleZone? I can honestly tell you, I don't pay an awful lot of attention to the entrance music, as in who it's by, what the artist is. I always love Scotty Swift's. I think that's Bad Religion with Sinister Rouge. That's on a playlist. That's on my Spotify. Of course, won't hear it anytime soon, but I love that. Aspen had a really cool one. It was by Schism, I think it was called. It was called Like This, I think it was. That was ace. I love that. Omar's is great because it's sensational, so you can't really go wrong. I like Bagos when he comes out, because it's not my kind of music really, but it gets you pumped, it gets you hyped for the show. And I like the Foundations and Futures music's ace as well, but you know, it doesn't really, sometimes the music doesn't really register for me. I just kind of go, oh, that's definitely so and so's music, and then I go see the wrestling. Who's on the Mount Rushmore of WrestleZone? Like I said, there was a little bit earlier about that. So Callum is saying Scotty Swift, Johnny Lyons, Damien, and Crusher Crabe. Pretty solid. I would definitely agree, Scotty. Scotty Swift being kind of like the franchise, the John Cena of WrestleZone in the Northeast. Absolutely, I'd have Scotty Swift on there. Johnny Lyons, 100%. Without Johnny Lyons, there's no WrestleZone. So I would have to have Johnny Lyons on there. Damien's a good shout. Crusher's a good shout. I want to throw one out there. That you know, I think should be on there because he's been there since year dot, and I would say William Sterling possibly. I mean, imagine having the his big rugby helmet as on the Mount Rushmore. I would possibly say William Sterling. I would put that name in there as well. Damien's probably would be my fourth, and that's nothing against Crusher. Crusher deserves to be on there as well. That's why this Mount Rushmore thing is always so controversial when you're starting it. So I would say Scotty Swift, Johnny Lyons, William Sterling, and yeah, I would say Damien as well. Damien would be my fourth. But you know, I'd have guys waiting in the wings. I'd have a Crusher Head there, Zach Dynamite, one as well. And we can go back through the past. Who's on the first show of Aberdeen Anarchy that's still around, still going? I mean, you got Alan Sterling as well. You can't really argue against Alan Sterling. I'd even say Blue Thunder probably should be in that conversation as well as your Mount Rushmore, because he's really break glass in case of emergency. If we need a fill in, Blue Thunder's there. But former tag team champion, and he's a guy that's on commentary now. He seems to be running a tight ship when it comes to setting up steel cages. I would put Blue Thunder as a contender in that also. So plenty of choices, but we definitely agree. I agree on absolutely three of them, being Scotty, Johnny Lyons, and I would say William Sterling would be my three absolute guarantees. That fourth one I'm not sure about though. I mean, you could even put the voice of WrestleZone, you could put Martin Clunas in there, but I would, you've started something, and I don't know the right answer in my head. I've got that three I'm happy with. It's that fourth one. Damien. I'm putting Damien. Scotty Swift, Johnny Lyons, William Sterling, Damien. That's my Mount Rushmore. Yeah. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Well, yes, we're going to go with that. And that's it. WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy has been previewed. And hopefully it's not a humongous episode. I mean, it's a humongous epic episode, but length time-wise, I hope it's not like a 3-hour event that I'm speaking about Aberdeen Anarchy, because, you know, as I said, tickets are sold out. So you're not going to be able to get one. You're going to have to wait until we're going to do a recap a couple of days after the show for the WrestleZone podcast. And then we'll have a road trip episode on our Scottish Wrestling Network as well. As we look at my journey, I might have a montage. Who knows? It's kind of on the fence, because I didn't do a montage for the last show. I had like 3 clips that I threw in. But just keep an eye out. We can do it. So you can follow us, Scottish Wrestling Network, elsewhere on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at ScottResNet. And look out for at WrestleZone on Twitter. And you can go onto Instagram, Wrestle Scotland on Twitter, and check them out on Facebook also. YouTube is probably a good place to go. So look up WrestleZone on YouTube. You can find out more. You can see the videos that we've put in here. You can also see free matches. You can see everything you need to know about WrestleZone. And you can go onto their website as well, which, if I remember rightly, and I'm just going to double check, because I like to make sure, it should be wrestlescotland.co.uk. But I'm just going to make sure that I am correct. It is wrestlescotland.co.uk. And you can find out more about the training, wrestling shows upcoming, and also birthday parties and everything else you want to know. You can check out roster things and all that jazz. So I can't wait for Aberdeen Anarchy. Hopefully you can't wait either. And we're going to be there on Saturday, the 13th of May at Danestone Community Centre. And we're going to have a great time. It's time for Anarchy. Let's do this.